matters of jurisdiction. Matters of jurisdiction. So first and foremost, class, when we talk of civil procedure and we talk of matters of jurisdiction, we should not forget that number one, there is what we call subject matter jurisdiction. The second one is subject matter over the person of the plaintiff. Number three is what? Jurisdiction over the person of the defendant. Later on, we'll discuss what? Original jurisdiction, concurrent jurisdiction, and special jurisdiction. Intindihin natin lahat yan isa-isa. Let me start with subject matter jurisdiction. Before I give you what I think you want to hear, Republic Act 7691, let me give you the 2015 case of Luis Gonzalez versus JGH Land. Okay, this is a November 2015 case. What happened to this? This involves an intracorporate dispute. Okay, pinagtatalunan dito intracorporate dispute. Ngayon, anong ginawa ng court? Okay, there was a motion to dismiss, saying that this court is not a special commercial court. You follow? It's not a special commercial court, and because it is not a special commercial court, that court had no jurisdiction. Nakita niya? Sabi niya, hindi ka naman hindi ka naman special court, so wala kang jurisdiction. So what did the court do? The RTC dismissed the case. Okay? So here, class, ang question dito, ganun, sabi niya, wala ba akong jurisdiction? And please bear in mind, this is what you call special jurisdiction in relation to original. Okay, ano nangyari? Dismissed ng RTC until such time it reached the Supreme Court. The Supreme Court was faced with that problem. Should it be dismissed? For the Supreme Court to explain it, the Supreme Court had a chance to explain it by making a distinction between subject matter jurisdiction from exercise of jurisdiction, sabi ng court. From subject matter jurisdiction, as you know, subject matter jurisdiction is what? Conferred by law. Nakita, maliwanag class ha? Ang batas ang nagsasabi kung anong husgado ang pwedeng humawak ng particular na kaso. Yun, subject matter jurisdiction. It is only the law that confers jurisdiction. Now, sir, how about exercise of jurisdiction? The court said that an RTC had what? Had jurisdiction for intracorporate disputes. Okay? The RTC has jurisdiction for intracorporate dispute, except that it has what? It's a question of exercise of jurisdiction. Can they exercise jurisdiction for us? Special commercial courts. The Supreme Court said exercise of jurisdiction is not a ground to dismiss the case. Di follow? In which case, ano sabi ng husgado? Susundan niyo ako, class? Dapat ba dismissin mo? No, because even under intercorporate rules, what does it say? The RTC has jurisdiction. Maliwanag sa batas. Nakita nyo? Doon ka muna, maliwanag sa batas. The RTC had jurisdiction, but the Supreme Court said what? That's just an exercise of jurisdiction. And therefore, should not result to a dismissal of the case. Ano sabi ng court? Ano ba dapat ginawa nyo yan? Tama, ha? Ano ba dapat ginawa nyo yan? That case should have been referred back to the executive judge for further reraffle, or if there is no more anyone available special commercial court, ano? If there's no longer any available special commercial court in the next or the nearest what? Judicial station. Okay? Yung pinakamalapit na judicial station. Okay? Yun ang sinabi. When I say pinakamalapit na judicial station, kunyari, ano, Quezon City, Marikina. Alam mo gano'n? Depende na sa executive judgment. Pero ang gusto kong tandaan ninyo, an exercise, a wrong exercise of jurisdiction, does not lead to a dismissal of the case. I'm still on subject matter jurisdiction, right? And it is what? Conferred by law. This is what I would want you to remember. Class, there are two figures or two amounts I would want you to remember for purposes of the bar. Para madali ninyong maaalala, ano amounts? In Metro Manila, exceeding 400,000 pesos. Outside of Metro Manila, exceeding 300,000 pesos. Yung munang figure na yun, gusto ko tandaan ninyo, okay? Yung munang figure na yun, gusto ko alam ninyo. Okay? So, sir, maliwanag. Okay, sandali lang. Class. Sir, what are those which are covered by this? 400 and 300. Let us be very clear. Recovery of sum of money or any other claim involving money. Okay? So, may hit 400,000, RTC. May hit 300,000, outside of Metro Manila, RTC. Maliwanag, class? Now, what else? How about estate claims or distribution of the estate, probate of the will? Is it dictated? Nasa Republic Act 7691 yun kasi. Okay, jurisdiction of courts. Okay, distribution of estate, probate of the will. What determines jurisdiction? It is the value of the estate. O, tandaan yun, ha? Value of the estate. Importante pa rin yung 400 and 300. Okay, o, pangalawa yun. Ano pa? Maritime claims. Okay, maritime claims. Still covered by that amount. 400 and 300 maritime claims. 400, 300. Gusto kong tandaan yung susunod. 50 and 20. Okay, I would want you to remember the amount of exceeding 50,000 pesos. Okay, exceeding 50,000 pesos where? In Metro Manila, outside of Metro Manila, exceeding 20,000 pesos. And this 50,000 pesos or 20,000 pesos refers to what? Assessed value. Tandaan yun, ha? Assessed value of what? Of property. Real property. Take note of this. Title to possession or interest over real property. Ito ang tatandaan nyo. Dinimanda recovery of title over a piece of land. What determines jurisdiction? Assessed value. Do you follow? Recovery over a piece of land. Recovery of what? Possession. Okay. Recovery of possession. Let's say, well, if it's purely an ejectment case, MTC, but it involves the real right of possession, okay, action publishana, it is determined by the assessed value of the property. Oh, maliwanag class tayo, ha? Are we clear? I hope we're clear. How about quieting of title? Ayan, ha? How about quieting of title? So, maliwanag naman sa inyo yung 50-20, title, possession, interest over real property, right? Ownership, possession, interest, okay yon.